they play the drums, like, good. I was probably like, you know, I was a young teen. And she was like, just come and play the drums. It was a small church, maybe 100 people. And I was like, nah, I don't really play the drums like that. Matter of fact, I was a hot mess, man. When I got on the drums, I was a hot mess. I didn't play that well at all. But she saw something in me that I didn't see in myself. And she said, get on those drums, bro. And I was like, I mean, I was off beat. I mean, I was messing up the people singing. But she didn't care. She just wanted my soul, man. So it actually killed any argument of whether or not a female can lead. How many know females can lead, too? I got saved for a female pastor. She wanted me in Christ, man. So I can't have a male, female. I don't care about that. Listen, you preaching the gospel, amen. I want to know Jesus. And she ushered me to Christ. And so through the years, when I was in Queens, I grew up in small churches like that. So I grew up on that gospel, right? When I got saved, that was a song you heard. I didn't hear background. I didn't hear, you know, some of the songs, you know, ooh, whoa, whoa, whoa. I came down with it. That's not what we heard, right? So, but it was all good. I was bumping Kirk Franklin, Fred Hammond, and all those, right? And so I remember I met a young lady, a beautiful young lady in a Christian club. That's where I met my wife, in a Christian club in Manhattan. Praise God. Praise God for Christian clubs. Right? So we had a Christian club, and you know, I met her, you know, one thing led to the next, whatever, I got to know her. But she introduced me to like contemporary worship, and I was like, nah, I don't know if I could do that. You know, I don't know if I do contemporary worship. I had never worshiped like that. In fact, when I brought that music back to my homies back at the, you know, back in the, you know, my small church, they was like, yo, what's this, man? What you doing to you, bro? Why you listening to this, man? So none of my music had like rock guitar or nothing like that. But God exposed me that it didn't matter, man. Like if it was an uplifting Jesus and the Spirit of God was moving, they don't care if it's, you know, if you got a meringue, whatever it is, I don't care no more. I was like, listen, if it's the Spirit of the Lord, I'm connected to it. Too much time our culture, our race gets into involved. But in heaven, man, everybody's worshiping, man. It's universal in heaven. God's got, listen, Jew, Greek, male, female, let's just be open, right? So praise God. And I remember the day. You know, I started getting feelings for my wife, and I was like, man, God, she's a cool friend, but man, she'd be an awesome wife. Like, you know, and so I was like, but I was scared, right? So I started, so I was kind of in and out. I was like, I like her. Nah, let me chill, man. I can't be doing that, man. I can't. Where you live at? Staten Island. Chill, I can't come to Staten Island. And I started getting cold feet. Right? You ever make a decision, and then you start like getting shaky on that decision? You don't follow through? All right, I'll be honest. Yes, that's happened to me several times. But this was a big decision. Like, you don't just up and leave your surroundings and just bounce like that. You know, like, I lived in Queens all my life. I had all my peoples there. You know, I walked down the block. I went to, you know, get, you know, beef patty, cheese, and cocoa bread at the corner store. Everybody knew me. I got my sandwich for $2.50. I was a hero for like $2.50. If you wanted lettuce, it was $3, you know, with tomato. But like now, it's the, you know, now Subway's changed the game a little bit. But I used to go to bodega all the time. That was why I grew up. That's why I was familiar with. And God instantly was challenging me on my familiar surrounding. And in order for me to go to my next season, I had to say yes to what God wanted me to do. And I was so nervous about it. I was like, I don't know. But how many know when you put faith involved, God's going to do something unreasonable, don't make sense. Man, on paper, I was the last brother that should have been married, okay? I was one of those guys, man. I don't even know how to tell people, like, how to work their relationships anymore. I'm like, I don't know, because when God married me, I wasn't sharp. I was like, you know, the knife was dull. Talk about not the sharpest knife in the box. I was definitely one of the dullest, man. I was like, I should not be married on paper, but God, when God does something, faith is just unreasonable, crazy, and you just can't explain it sometimes. And if you say yes, God's going to open new doors, and he's going to show you relationships beyond that, and then you don't even know what God's going to open. And so tonight, you know, tonight's message reminded me of that. You know, reminded me of the time when I left. And in fact, before I left Queens, people were so upset with me for leaving. And, you know, there was so much more involved with it. But I praise God that I made the right decision. But it influenced me that I talk about a message. Today I'm going to talk about a message. It's called Faith First. Faith First. Praise God. Praise God. Let's pray. Father, I just thank you.